Yes, you're welcome. And today we are going to look at how to start a hospital here in Uganda. You might be a Ugandan and you're in the diaspora, you made your money, and you really want to start up a hospital in Uganda here. Or you might be an investor and you have your money, and one of the investment opportunities for you is to start up a hospital here in Uganda. Now, you don't need to be a doctor to start up a hospital here in Uganda. You just need to have the right amount of money and also the right people to guide through you through on how to start up a hospital here in Uganda. Now, the type of hospital we are going to talk about is basically a general hospital. A general hospital is a step above a health center and a step right below a regional referral hospital. If you are really new to this channel, my name is Jacob, and basically here we talk about businesses like this, starting up clinics, hospitals, drug shops. I've made very many videos on how to start up drug shops, clinics, pharmacies. If you are really interested in some of those videos, just go and look out in my description section. I've left out some of those videos. So if you really enjoy my content, consider subscribing to the channel and click a thumbs up so that this tutorial can be promoted to other people like you who really enjoy our content. Now, if you really have anything you want to communicate or you want to suggest on this video, just consider mentioning it and making your comment right there in the comments. First in time, we are going to talk about the procedure you need to go through to start a hospital, the requirements, and the total cost for you to start a hospital here in Uganda. General hospital, like all other businesses, you need to have enough land for you to set up. Some people change their apartments into hospitals. That's all okay, as long as you can build at least 3 blocks, that's enough for you. Then you need to have your hospital inspected. Like all other businesses in the medical, inspection is very important. An inspection of a hospital takes only 300,000 shillings. Then also your bed capacity is very important for you to get a license to start up a hospital in Uganda. A hospital of a bed capacity, inpatient of 21 to 50, can take you a cost of around 1 million shillings. That's the amount of money or the license cost for you for a bed capacity of around 21 to 50 beds of your hospital. Beds above 50, you need to pay more money for your license. Now, to get a license for a general hospital, basically you need to get a doctor. A general doctor with around 3 years of experience can get you a license to start up a general hospital here in Uganda. Now, we are going to look at the total cost of how to start up a general hospital here in Uganda. So we are going to look at the estimated cost of starting up a general hospital here in Uganda. A hospital just a level below a regional referral hospital and just a level above a health center. For that's what we call a general hospital. And we are going to look at the estimated cost of starting up a general hospital here in Uganda. I'm going to look at only the essential things which you don't have to miss when you are starting up a hospital, a general hospital here in Uganda. So let's look at maternity in your hospital. What are the estimated costs of starting up a maternity and antenatal? So basically you need 5 delivery sets. Each roughly costs around 1 million shillings, and those can go to 5 million shillings. Then you also need roughly 2 delivery beds. That's around each around 1.3 million shillings. So that one can take you to 2.6 million shillings. You will need on average 2 examination beds. Each roughly can be 300,000 shillings. That can take you to around 600,000 shillings. Then other things, sundries and all those other necessary things can cost you around 5 million. So on average, you need around 13.2 million to set up your antenatal and maternity, basically essential things. Then let's look at the cost of an operating theater, which will be needed in your general hospital.
So basically, I'm chosen an anesthetic machine is the most important thing there in your operating theater. And I've chosen a machine which can be used for each person, either even hospitals in the village. That is the universal anesthetic machine. This one can even work on alcohol saturator. It's a quite a very good machine. Roughly, this one will cost you around 20 million shillings. Then an average theater table can take you around 1 million shillings. A suction machine, 1.3 million shillings. Oxygen concentrator, 3 million shillings. Cardiac monitor, 1 million shillings. Basically for an average theater. Then sets which will be needed in your operation room, you'll need at least 5 C-section sets. Each one can cost you at around 1.6 million shillings. These are JMC prices. So 5 of them, that can take you roughly around 8 million shillings. Yes, then you will need 5 minor sets. Each can cost you around 1.2 million shillings. So 5 of them can take you around 6 million shillings. Then 5 D&C sets, each can take you at around 1.4 million shillings. Roughly, that's 7 million shillings in total. Then other things which can be needed in your theater, like sutures, gowns, and all those other extra things, roughly 5 million shillings. So your average cost for a theater can take you around 49.3 million shillings. That is the cost for your theater. Then let's look at the laboratory. A laboratory in a general hospital, we are going to look at the most important things which are needed. So you need at least 3 microscopes. And each microscope can take you around 1.5 million shillings. So basically 3 of them can take you to 4.5 million shillings. Then you will need at least a hematology analyzer, which other people call a CBC machine. That one on average cost can take you around 14 million shillings. You'll need a chemistry analyzer. That one can take you also 7 million shillings. Any other strips and reagents roughly can take you around 5 million shillings. So basically, when you are calculating to set up an average laboratory in your hospital, it can take you around 30.5 million shillings. So the next thing, let's look at the dental services. What do you need to set up a good dental clinic in your general hospital? One of the most important things is a dental chair. A good one, an average one, can take you around 1 million shillings. Then you need dental instrument set, at least 3 of them. Each can cost you around 1 million shillings, JMC prices. So 3 of them will take you around 3 million shillings. Then other things which will be needed can cost you around 3 million shillings. So an average dental clinic will take you around 7 million shillings. Then another thing we need to put in our hospital, which is quite very important, is a radiology department. So to start, on average, of course, you cannot get everything like CT scans, MRI, but there are things which you have to start on, like an X-ray machine. That was quite very important. So an average X-ray machine will need around 70 million shillings on average. Then another thing is an ultrasound scan machine in your radiology department will take you average the 20 million shillings. Then other things which you may use in your department, let's calculate them to be 5 million shillings. So roughly, to set up your radiology unit when you are just limited to scanning an X-ray can take you roughly 95 million shillings without licenses for opening up a radiology unit. Those ones, I've left them out. I'm going to calculate them differently. But for a simple one, for where you are just going to do X-ray and ultrasound scan, roughly 95 million is the total cost on average. Then in your general hospital, you also need a mini pharmacy. Setting up a mini pharmacy can take you around 20 million. Let's also calculate the layout of the inpatient admission room. Let's consider this hospital to be a 50-bed hospital, a maximum for the beginning. So a layout of a 50-bed hospital If we consider beds, let's calculate beds for a 50-bed hospital. Each bed, let's calculate it to go at 300,000 shillings. So basically, for 50 beds in such an inpatient area, a narrow one can take you around 15 million, accounting for only beds, which are not these fancy hospital beds, the local ones, which are quite simple. Just take 50 beds to take you around 15 million. Then other things which will be needed for your inpatient services, drip stands, sundries, and furniture, can take you around 12 million shillings. Then let's look at the outpatient layout. The outpatient layout, furniture, examination beds, sundries, reception design, I've estimated it to take 12 million shillings. Then inspection costs for your hospital, roughly it's around 300,000 shillings. Then let's look at the licenses which you will need in your hospital. So basically, in your hospital, you need to get a license for your pharmacy. That one will be around 600,000 shillings. Then a license for your laboratory in the hospital, 300,000 shillings. Then the radiology unit, your license, will take you around 800,000 shillings. So basically, your total expenditure plus the license for operating this general hospital, which is estimated to be 1 million shillings. So license costs and all the inspections for your hospital, I've estimated them to be around 4.7 million shillings. Then another thing which you need in your hospital is a big autoclave. A big autoclave, I remember in other tutorials, talked about small autoclave, but a big autoclave which is going to sterilize all your instruments in the hospital will cost you at least around roughly 9 million shillings. So on average, these are the most essential things which you need to set up your general hospital. So without the building costs, if you are not going to build, let me say you have a place which you have, and you are not going to build, probably some people change their buildings into their apartments into hospitals. But if you are adding building, a building for a general hospital, three blocks can take you around 300 million shillings. I'm estimating that each block can take you around 100 million shillings. So to build up and set up a building for your general hospital, can take you around 300 million shillings. So the total cost plus a building to set up a general hospital can take you around 568 million shillings. But if you already have a building in place, let me say you are changing your home into a general hospital and you already have a building and you are not going to incur building costs. Basically, the estimated cost for setting up a general hospital can take you around 268 million shillings on average. So basically, this is a simple tutorial and estimated cost of setting up your general hospital here in Uganda. So now let's look at the human resource of your hospital. Those are the staffs you need to hire in your general hospital. I'm going to only look at the medical staffs, the ones who are going to run the hospital. The non-medical, I'm not going to dwell so much on them because there are so many. And those ones you can hire out as you please. But I'm going to dwell basically on the medical staff, those ones which you need to work with in the hospital. The ones who are going to run your hospital in the medical section. So basically you will need around three doctors to run your hospital. And also you'll need around three clinical officers who run especially the outpatient department. You'll need roughly an average of 12 nurses, some four on the outpatient, then inpatient you can also put like four, then the other nurses can run the clinics. And then you'll need at least six midwives in your hospital to run the maternity and antenatal on the average. then you need at least 4 laboratory technicians. You can do either 2 laboratory technicians and 2 laboratory assistants, as you wish, but I think 4 of them can handle your laboratory very well. Then you need at least 4 theater assistants. Yeah, you can hire theater assistants or nurses. But roughly, nowadays people prefer theater assistants to run theaters because they are very experienced. Then the part-time staffs, you need at least dental officers. Dental officers, you may not hire them, because most of the dental clinics run dental days, so hiring them sometimes can be costly for the hospital. So it's good for them to come just for a clinic and they get paid. Then the anesthetic officers, for the beginning, you can also not hire them. They can come basically on a part-time basis, and they work as they are paid as cases appear. Sometimes hiring them can be very costly for the beginning, but it all depends on your money. Radiographers, I believe, should also be part-time staff, because in the beginning you may not get so many cases for x-ray and scanning. So they should also be part-time staffs, and they are paid according to the procedures. A pharmacist should also be a part-time staff. That one can also be taken among our consultants. So other consultants like gynecologists, surgeons, pediatricians, any person who comes for consultations to run part of your clinics, those ones don't need to be hired. They can be part-time staffs. They can be paid per procedure they make. So basically, in brief, this is the staffing you need for your general hospital to run very well on a medical side. So now we are going to look at the sketch map of our general hospital, the general layout, the sketch map of how your hospital will appear after it being built, or the general setup of your hospital on a sketch map. Yeah, so basically this is a sketch map of our general hospital here in Uganda. Like you've seen, we need 3 blocks, the one I talked about in the tutorial. 3 blocks, this 1, 2, and 3. Basically it's enough. Some people, when it's a flat, it's another sketch map, but this one is basically there are 3 blocks on a plain land. So basically what you need to set up is this as your outpatient area. So this is the reception, this is the waiting area, this is OPD. These 2 rooms are doctor's rooms for clerking. It can be clinical officer or doctor. Then this is a mini pharmacy where the patients will get their drugs. This is a treatment area, then a lab where they will get their investigations. So all these need to be on the first floor of your block. And then here, I put a dental clinic. It's also very important on your first floor. Then here is a radiology room where they will take x-ray and scan. Then another area on the second block, we have an operating theater here, which is very important. The operating theater needs to be near maternity and antenatal, because in case of any C-section and emergency, they can easily rush here for an operation. So basically I put antenatal here and maternity here. Then after that, recovery from maternity postnatal is here for post C-section mothers and post delivery mothers, can be here. Then these are general ward inpatient. You can separate them from male and female. That one is also acceptable. So you need the general ward here for inpatient. Then you can put an administration block here. So basically these are the basic and a sketch map for a general hospital, a simple general hospital. If you want other many services, ICU, although that is way too higher than a general hospital. But for just a general hospital, this is a format and a simple layout which you can use if you want set up one. So thank you very much for listening and watching my tutorial.